As a first step, first level of security, what we can optionally enable is a secured browser where the candidate will not be able to move out of the test layer. Every candidate will be having a unique ID and a password which they need to enter. What they will be seeing is the candidate information, where the name of the candidate can appear here, their unique ID number can appear here, their fit picture can appear here. Once they confirm that all these details are correct, they'll see an instruction sheet where all the information about the examination is given. What kinds of questions are there in the exam, how many sections are there, what is the total duration of the exam, any negative markings involved. All these details are mentioned in the instruction sheet along with the navigational instructions. So the candidate can go through these instructions and they will be aware, or they will be comfortable to navigate through the test layer. Once they confirm that they have read and understood the instructions, they can start the exam. What the candidate will see is an agreement sheet, where we will be taking a consent from the candidate that they do not have any handheld device or any supporting material like notes or books along their side. They also acknowledge the fact that we will be recording their face and eye movements, the screen and navigation actions, and the background noise in the room. Once the candidate agrees to all these terms and conditions, they'll move to the next step, where the system will get into an automatic equipment check. So the system will check for the compatible browser. We support the latest versions of all the browsers, be it Chrome, Firefox, Edge, or even Safari. The system will check if the webcam is enabled or not, if the microphone is enabled or not for recording the background noise, and if an adequate network connection is in place. If the webcam or microphone is not enabled, then in case of a few browsers like Chrome and Firefox, a pop-up will appear on the left top screen, so the candidate can easily allow the access of these two tools. Okay. Finally, once all the checks and balances are in place, the candidate will move to the next level, where he or she will have to capture a profile picture. The AI algorithm will be benchmarking this profile picture and will be running all the rules across this picture. As a final step, the candidate will have to share the screen to allow the recording of the screen and navigation actions. You see a bubble out here where the candidate is getting a self view. It serves two purposes. One is to keep the candidate conscious of the fact that even though he or she is giving the exam remotely, still there is a system or a live proctor keeping an eye on the candidate. And second purpose is to throw an alert whenever the candidate is violating any of the rules. So as I'm continuously speaking, the system has detected and has thrown an alert that there is a conversation or noise in the background. This is the test layer. The top header bar is completely customizable. We can have the corporate or institution's logo out here. Even the color scheme can be modified to meet the branding guidelines of the institution. There is a clock which is ticking, so we can configure the duration of the exam. There can be additional resources which can be provided, like the initial instruction sheet in case the candidate wants to refer it during the time of the exam. Or at any point, if the candidate wants to see the summary report, they can see the summary at a section level or at an individual question level from this report itself. Some tools like a calculator can be provided to the candidate. All of it is configurable. The first section which we see out here has all MCQ kind of questions. We support 12 different kind of questions. For this particular demo examination, we have MCQ kind of questions in the first section. So if I'm aware of the answers, I can simply give my option and proceed to the next question using the next and previous button out here, or I can navigate by clicking on the respective question in the number panel. If I'm not sure of a particular question, I can mark it for a later review, or if I'm confused between few options, I can answer the question, but I can still mark it for a later review. So as you can see, all the actions that I'm taking is resulting in the change in color and shape of the question in this number panel. The legends are available here. If say 5 minutes or a few minutes are remaining in the exam and I just want to see the questions which are not visited or I have marked for a later review, I can do so using the filter options available here. We also support descriptive kind of questions. So as you can see, there is a typing area which is available to the candidate, where the candidate can type the answers. Even a table can be inserted here. There are special characters available for mathematical, economics, or any kind of examination. What we optionally allow is this kind of an upload option. See, if a question requires the candidate to draw something or scribble something on a piece of paper and upload it as a supporting to the answer, the candidate can do so by clicking on the upload option, and they can upload the file, and all those material will be available to the faculties online on their screen so that they can see the answers which candidates have given and give the grades. So you might not be seeing the end test option for this particular test. We can enable it only on the last question of the last section or after the candidate has spent some amount of time on the test, so that candidate does not complain later on that I clicked on the end test by mistake. And even when they click on the end test button, there will be a two-level confirmation that we will be taking from the candidate. First, we will be showing them the attempt summary, so that they are conscious of the fact that they have not answered a couple of questions, they have marked some of the questions for review. Even then, if they want to proceed and submit the test, they'll have to confirm at a final level that they want to submit and end the test attempt at this stage. Right? So when they confirm, click on the confirm option, the test will end and the candidate's attempt will be recorded.